In this video, we're going to take a look at the JBL GTO 329 3.5-inch speakers. It's a really high-quality speaker. Here you have the stock, the kicker, the JBL, all sealed basket, really high quality, real nice. Now, the top mount depth is even less than stock, so the depth into the dash is not a problem. The top area here is the problem, hitting the cover. However, the tweet is just in a tiny spot around this whole rim. This rim is what is going to be the obstruction. I already did a test fit. So I'm going to first use these dash adapters I got from Crutchfield, which are a little harder to find in places. They're not the 6x9 ones are much bigger. Those are easy to find. The dash ones, you can almost barely find those anywhere. I got them at Crutchfield. And this came just like this. It's going to be a perfect direct snap-in, and I can connect it here. I want to do a side-by-side comparo again before I start hacking these, just to make sure, see how they sound. These are 3-ohm speakers. I specifically chose that, and they are 91 dB sensitivity, which is very good. So hopefully these might sound a bit better than these. If they do, then I'll have to look into trimming this outer bucket, and I think they will fit under the dash at that point. All right, just for consistency, we're gonna listen to the same song. If you don't like this song, sorry about that. It'll still be a good comparison. We have the JBL on the left and the stock speaker on the right. Start out in the center. I'm gonna fade up to the front. All right, we're gonna start with the JBL.
Must be getting early. Clocks are running late. Paint by the morning sky.
Swap over to stop.
So phony.
Back to JBL. Back to stop. JBL one last time.
Say a piece and get out. Yes, I get the gist of it, but it's all right. Sorry that you feel that way.
The only thing that... I don't know, man. That stock one sounds good again. I can't believe it. The JBL, it sounds more high, more highs, less mid. I'm not using a cap on it or anything that came with it. It's just a straight plug-in. The stock wiring should take care of that. I don't know if the JBL sounds better. Maybe it doesn't. I gotta think real careful here before I start hacking it all up. I can sell them now pretty easily. If I hack them all up and still don't like them, then I'm gonna have a real problem getting rid of them. But there you go, JBL versus the stock. You know, if you listen back to that kicker versus stock video, if I'm real honest, I think the kicker did sound better than the JBL. It at least sounded better, just not as loud, but the sound was, I think, higher quality. On this JBL, I just don't sense the same kind of sound quality there. Kind of disappointing. I mean, bottom line, if you have the Super B, six speaker 275 whatever watt system, maybe some others besides Super B have it, I honestly recommend you don't waste time with any changing any of these speakers. I've determined as of now I'm not even going to bother with any 6x9 testing at all. This dash has told me enough. To me and my ears, the stock speakers sound better than the two aftermarkets that I tried. So there's one obvious solution, which is a lot better than this. You add a sub in the back and keep everything here. It would really knock the system out of the park. For me, it's nothing special, but I could deal with it right now. If I add a sub, forget about it. It'd be real nice for me. And they do make, it might be a pack or a different brand here, an adapter that plugs in line to your actual head unit harness with RCA pigtails on it. So it's super clean. It also has a remote turn on circuit on it. So it goes in line, no cutting wires, tapping into cheap speaker wires. It's a true RCA from behind the harness. I don't know any more info on it. I've just been reading a long thread about it on the Charger forums. You have to hunt for it. If I was going to upgrade anything, that's what I'd do. I'd go RCAs, behind the deck, super clean. At the time I do that harness, I'd also run an RCA and a remote turn on to the trunk. Then, of course, your battery's in the trunk, so it's super easy to do an amp and a sub. Sub could be a box if you don't mind trunk space, or the sub could be real shallow, slim, to go in your center rear deck if you do have that spot available. But I would not mess with any of these interior speakers on the six speaker setup. That's my final results here. It just doesn't sound better.